Good evening. So, are you able to hear me? Yeah, good evening. So we'll begin with the session now. Okay, so as we are aware, most of you are the regular students here, so you are aware that we are doing this crash course on ecology and environment. In last month, that is April, we have done 10 sessions on this, that is 10 classes or 10 parts, right? So we are continuing with the same course in the month of May also. We will be again up to your prelims exam. We'll be doing 10 more lessons on this. So total 20, and we'll be going to cover most of the important and critical topics of this ecology and environment segment. Okay. So for those who are new, for them, you can just follow me on Unacademy as Rizwan Space MD in category of UPSC Civil Services Examination. Okay. So most of these courses will be in English in Unacademy app also. So this is a crash course live session on ecology and environment for the prelims examination 2019, part 11 of this course today, right? So a brief introduction. Myself, Md Rizwan. I am teaching live on Unacademy, and that is Plus platform, okay, apart from the free platform, as you are aware of. And and these are the structured courses for the prelims and mains. Okay, I have been teaching for civil services last 14 years, and my areas of specialization includes geography optional, ecology environment, and disaster management. Okay, so here I'm doing this session, that is for ecology particularly, to help you all for the prelims examination, right? Now what are the topics we will be doing ahead now? So up to yesterday's class, we have discussed like the forest. Then we have discussed about national forestry, also national forest policy. Then Indian state of forest report we have discussed, okay? And yesterday we were discussing about what are National Wildlife Action Plan, Wildlife Protection Act, just an introduction of Wildlife Protection Act, and what is a Global Wildlife Program. Now from this class onwards, I'll do the species specific conservation in India. These are the basic topics, plus you will have some current related things also. Related to certain species which are protected by the special measures taken by Government of India, or this may be, there can be international collaboration, regional collaborations are also there, where there are efforts, okay, there are efforts taken for conservation of these species. Okay, now today we are going to discuss about vultures. So conservation of vultures in India, and in general we can say conservation of vulture across the globe and South Asia, right? So what we will cover in this topic, we'll discuss what is the significance of vultures, what is the distribution or habitat of vulture, why there is a decline, or how this decline was reported, and what causes the decline of vultures, and what are the efforts or measures taken for conservation. Okay, I hope these things are clear for you. this is, that is from today. I'm starting here, the species specific conservation, right? So now this is one type. As a general understanding, I have just kept a picture for you that you can understand how one particular genus, one particular type of vulture it is. Okay, so see the beak here and see the head here. Okay, but these vultures may differ in their colors. Okay, they may differ in their neck also. Neck size generally differ hota hai from one genus to other. Beak size also will differ, beak shape also. Some vultures will have a big beak like this. Okay, and they may differ in their body shapes also. So they are generally categorized and classified based on the their shape of the bodies, their size of the neck and the size of their beaks. Okay, they are going to be differentiated. The vultures can be differentiated. Okay, so now what are these? Obviously these are the birds or avian species now. And vultures are the scavengers. Okay, they are the scavengers. So I'll cover some very basic and important information here. So what is vulture? Vulture is a scavenger. Okay, scavenger, that is mostly feeding on the carcasses of the dead animal, that is the remains of the dead animals or dead bodies. Okay, dead bodies of the animals they will feed. Now what is the important characteristic of the vulture? The gastric acid, okay, that is present in the intestine of these vultures, in the stomach of their these species, is extremely corrosive in nature. Okay, extremely corrosive. So extremely corrosive means it makes this vulture able to digest even this dead matter which is infested by, or it has a dangerous bacteria. Means what? They have the unique ability because of this gastric acid, a strong acid which is present in their stomachs. They have a ability to digest the bacteria which are produced, okay, in the dead matters. Okay, and see the bald head, there is an adaptation of vulture. We can say this is a bald head, okay, for which the vultures are known, is another adaptation due to their feeding behavior. Means you can see in the previous this also, they don't have hairs on the head here. They don't have hairs like this. Okay, so this is any genus you take, they will have a bald head. Now why this bald head, from where they got this bald head, is because when the vultures they feed, they enter into the dead body. Means they will push their mouth into the dead body, and over a period, because of this type of continuous, we can say, intrusions or continuous habit, they lost their hairs. Okay, means this is a kind of, I told you that over a period the species will be getting adjusted to the conditions of the ecosystem. So here it is considered as a food niche of the vulture, food specialization of the vulture, and because of their this type of behavior, they have lost their hairs. Okay, so that is bald headed creatures they are known as, right? So remember, this is a type of adaptation due to the feeding behavior of the vultures, right? So, and then you have necrophagous behavior. This term is important for us. This can be there in your options also. Consuming the dead animals. Okay, consuming the dead animals, that is known as necrophagous. Okay, necrophagous is the behavior wherein the animal, one animal, is feeding on the dead matter, right? So now let us assume that if these vultures are not there in the habitat, what will happen? There will be natural decomposition of this dead matter. Okay, decomposition will be there, and if decomposition is there, there will be multiplication of these microorganisms, bacteria, viruses. They will multiply, and these are going to spread this infection, spread the diseases in the entire ecosystem. Okay, entire ecosystem, and this will be right. So this is going, so the vultures prevent the spreading of diseases, okay, spreading of diseases such as anthrax and rabies. Okay, you can in general also remember that the vultures are responsible for preventing the spread of diseases which otherwise will be caused by the decomposition of the dead matter, right? So now, if you see with where they are present, globally, what is the population of vulture? Except Australia and Antarctica, these two locations, Australia and Antarctica, 23 different species of vulture are found across the globe. Only two land masses will not have these species. Okay, important. Okay, except Australia and Antarctica. They are found at all the places, and there are in total there are 23 species, and they are classified into two groups, right? They are classified into two groups. One is old world vultures and new world vultures. Okay, so this is a categorization of, that is global category we are talking about, not about India. We'll take up India after this. So classified into two groups, that is old world vultures and new world vultures. So seven species of vultures make up the new world vultures that are found throughout Americas, that is North America and South America. And old world vultures, okay, they consist of Africa, Asia and Europe. Okay, so remember the countries or continents also, new world vultures, that is North America and South America, and Africa, Asia and Europe, this is old world, right? This whatever I have explained here is important again for your exam. Now what is the difference between these two, that is old and new world? It depends on this classification, or this division is based on, depends on the site to find the food, how they approach the food, how they reach the food. This is going to differentiate. This is going to differentiate between the new world vultures and old world vultures. So what is there? The new world vultures have very good sense of smell and can smell the dead animals from the distance up to 2 kilometers. Right? Are you getting this? So new world vultures, we can say they are more adapted here. Okay, more adapted, or greater, we can say, ability by which they can smell the dead matter. Okay, dead matter from a longer distances compared to the old world vultures. Means what? They are the product of ecological succession. They have stabilized themselves in a better manner, right? So this species is basically inhabited in the regions where you have a semi-dry conditions, okay, semi-dry deciduous type of vegetation, and they don't inhabit the regions of cold conditions. Okay, so they are not inhabiting the regions of very cold or extremely cold conditions, right? So that is what we are saying, vulture habitat. Okay, vulture habitat. So dry and deciduous vegetation. Okay, so major habitat, or most of the habitats of vulture, consist of deciduous vegetation, and wherein the rainfall is less than 150, 175, 125, 100 centimeters, and they inhabit the areas where the temperatures are high, there are warm conditions, Right. So if you see these conditions in India, right. So what you will find this region, okay, this region of the country, this side will be more suitable, okay, more suitable for the vulture compared to this or compared to northeastern region, because northeast mein kya hai, evergreen hai, evergreen forest hai. In case of the western ghats also this will be evergreen forest here. So what are the major states in India where you can find this vulture population? So it starts from Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan, then Maharashtra, Gujarat, Karnataka, the parts of Telangana, and you'll find in Tamil Nadu also. So this, because see, if you are drawing, what is the meaning of this line what I'm drawing here? This is not just a rough thing. Here it is 100 centimeter. 100 centimeter iso height. Okay, 100 centimeter iso height means all these shaded region are going to get the rainfall around 100 or less than 100. Okay, now what is meaning of deciduous forest? It is opposite to evergreen. The deciduous forest means where the vegetation has the property of shedding the leaves. Okay, when there is no availability of water, the leaves, there is a shedding season, leaf shedding season, that will be considered as deciduous vegetation. Yes, are you able to understand this? Hope up to this point it is clear. So that necrophagous, okay, the adaptation types, okay, old world and new world, and what is the difference between old world and new world vultures, this you should remember. Okay, these are very critical things, and there are in all 23 species, 23 different species of vultures. Right. So before decline, we can look at what is the significance. Then what is the significance of vultures? Number one, vultures act as a keystone species. They are the keystone species. Vultures, they are acting as a keystone species. Now tell me, what is a keystone species? We have discussed in the previous sessions also. What is the meaning of a keystone species? Yeah, like tiger, ठीक है, लेकिन what is the keystone? What the word keystone implies? Pillars of food chain. Okay. They can adapt themselves and create a new species, no food chain species. Why you are connecting this unnecessarily to the food chain? See, keystone species are those which determine the balance of the ecosystem. Means those species which are going to determine the stability of the ecosystem is known as a keystone species. Matlab kya hai? If these species are removed from the ecosystem, the ecosystem will collapse. The conditions of the ecosystem will decline, get deteriorated. This type of species will be known as a keystone, right? For example, you take soil as an ecosystem. Earthworm will be considered as a keystone species. Okay, the health of the soil is determined by the presence of earthworm, right? Stability of the soil, it contributes to the stability. Similarly, the health of this ecosystem, health of this forest is dependent on the vultures. If vultures are not there, if vultures are eliminated, they become extinct. In such cases, you may find that the forest ecosystem will start getting collapsed, right? So therefore, they are referred as a keystone species. Then they are also important from the cultural aspect. Okay, cultural aspects or cultural importance of vulture. What is cultural importance? Some of the religions, some of the communities we have wherein the last rites, okay, last rites, the dead body is given to these vultures. Okay, so like you have in Parsis, it will be there. Okay, so that is known as a Tower of Silence. Not only in India, but there are several communities in Africa also wherein they will be feeding the dead bodies, okay, dead bodies to the vultures. There is a belief system by which they will feed these dead bodies to the vultures. Okay, so this is considered as the cultural significance. So two important things: vultures are important for the stability of the ecosystem. It is important for stability, and they are also having some cultural significance, right? So why this population of vultures is declining, or when we started recording this decline in population of vultures? So the first decline was reported in 1992, which was reported in Rajasthan in Keoladev National Park. Okay, Keoladeo, Keoladev National Park, right? So here there was a decline. There was a decline in vulture population. Then this was followed by the state of Maharashtra, Punjab, Haryana, Karnataka, and consecutively we are seeing and we are recording the decline itself. Up to now also, there is no stability. There is no stability in the population of many of these types of vultures. Okay. Now the question here was, why is this vulture population declining? What causes the decline in vulture population? So initially, when investigations were done or when the reports came in, most of the ecologists believed that they were not having sufficient food to eat. The vultures were dying because there was absence of food for them. They were not having sufficient food. Okay, but the deeper investigation into all this led to the conclusion that it was not the problem of food. Right, it was the problem of the dead bodies or dead matter, that is particularly the cattle, which were infected by NSAID. NSAID, that is known as diclofenac sodium. Okay, diclofenac, or simply you can use diclofenac. Okay, so it was a diclofenac sodium, a chemical which was found in the dead bodies of the cattle, which is going to enter into the body of vulture. Okay, it is going to enter into body of vulture, and because of this chemical these vultures were dying. Okay, so this diclofenac is referred as NSAID. This is known as non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory treat drug. Okay, so diclofenac is generally a painkiller, and even it is there in case of human use also. Okay, the same injection will be there, that and even all your ointments that you apply for as a painkiller, मुंह वॉलनी जितना भी है इसमें भी डाइक्लोफेनेक होता है. ओके, इट इज अ पेन किलर बेसिकली, एंड दिस इज यूज इन वेटरनरी फॉर ट्रीटिंग द कैटल्स. ओके, ट्रीटिंग द कैटल्स एंड दिस रिमेन इन टू द बॉडी ऑफ कैटल. When the cattle die and the vulture feed on these dead bodies, this chemical from cattle body, it enters into the body of vulture. The problem with this chemical is it causes renal failure in vulture. Okay, means the body of vulture will not be able to tolerate this chemical. It is something like bioaccumulation, wherein the pollutant or a harmful chemical, toxic chemical, harmful, here you say harmful chemical, is entering from one species to other species, right? So reasons for the decline. So diclofenac is a common anti-inflammatory drug administered to the livestock and used to treat the symptoms of inflammation, fever, pain associated with the diseases or wound, right? And diclofenac leads to the renal failure in the vulture, damaging their excretory system. Okay, so see, this is also found in case of human. Excessive use of painkillers will affect the kidneys, right? Renal failure is related to kidney failure. Okay, so this is going to cause a renal failure in vultures, and out of all the species, this gyps species, or gyps species, it is known as GYPES, is the most affected species by diclofenac. Please remember this. Okay, ठीक है. सो दिस स्पेसीज आउट ऑफ ऑल दिस जिप्स स्पेसीज इज द मोस्ट अफेक्टेड स्पेसीज बाय डाइक्लोफेनाक, वेर इन देयर पॉपुलेशन हैज डिक्लाइन. ओके, डिक्लाइन अप टू 99% फ्रॉम 1993 टू 2002, राइट? तो इसका पॉपुलेशन, सो रैपिड डिक्लाइन इन वल्चर पॉपुलेशन वॉज रिकॉर्डेड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर in this particular species. Yes, have you understood this point here? Right, so that is what is we want to say, Parvinder. The next coming is the population of Indian vulture, that is known as Gyps indicus. Okay, indicus, and slender billed vulture. Okay, this is known as tenurostris. Okay, tenurostris has fell to 97. So, इसमें क्या होगा? All these category of Gyps, GYPS, they have been now rendered as critically endangered, all these because of their decline. What is the parameter for any species to be declared as critically endangered species? If you find that their population is declining up to 80% decline in population is recorded, such species will be rendered as critically endangered. This is the criteria of one of the criteria of IUCN. Okay, IUCN in categorization. Okay, but you see, in this all the three, what we are finding is that the population has declined more than 99%, right? 97, 98, 99. So, ye sab kya hoga? They will now are the status of all this is critically endangered, right? Now, the percentage differs slightly because the white-rumped vulture is more sensitive to diclofenac than the other two species. Okay, so white-rumped vulture, what we have discussed in the previous slide, okay, why it has declined to 99, it is more sensitive to diclofenac, it is more affected by diclofenac, right? So the two other species, that is Himalayan vultures and Eurasian griffon, Himalayan vultures and Eurasian griffon, that is, were less affected, okay, because they are migratory in nature. They are not the resident of India. Okay, they are migratory, means they are coming. Okay, they are coming to India in certain duration only, for certain duration. Okay, and they are their habitat. Okay, their habitat will be the mountainous region, so they are less affected by this diclofenac contamination. Means we are trying to understand. Okay, we are trying to understand that why particular species is going into the category of critically endangered, why it is declining rapidly, and why others are not. Okay, because their inhabitations is differing there. Okay, and their characteristic also differ. So vulture population have continued to decline in India at the rate between 20 to 40% each year. Okay, important. The vulture population in India has declined between 20 to 40% each year since 2007. Right? See, when the vulture is affected, okay, or infected, you say, by this diclofenac, it shows this behavior. Okay, are you able to see? This fellow is sitting on the branch of the tree and putting the head down. Okay, this is a behavior. This is the behavior of the species. Okay, behavior of the species when it is getting infected by this diclofenac, and this phenomenon or this behavior is referred as neck drooping. Are you able to understand this? Neck drooping is, by sighting this vulture, by seeing the vulture itself, you can say that this is affected or infected by this diclofenac. Okay, it puts its head down, right? So important term, behavioral aspect is there. Like we have said, necrophagus. Okay, necrophagus, this is another term, that is neck drooping. Yes, are you able to get this? Now, if not diclofenac, then what should be there? Now, what government has taken as an initiative is the diclofenac is banned for veterinary use in India from 2006. Okay, the manufacture use of diclofenac in veterinary. Okay, in veterinary practices is completely banned from 2006. The replacement drug is known as meloxicam. Okay, meloxicam. This is another NSAID. Okay, which is an alternative to diclofenac. Okay, meloxicam affects the cattle in the same way as diclofenac, but it is harmless to the vulture. Okay, what is the characteristic of this drug meloxicam? It is going to have the same impact, same, we can say, effect on the cattle, same relief it will provide to the cattle, and it is not going to, when it remains into the body of cattle, it is not harming the vulture, right? So then, if the government has done this, why is that the vulture population, even after 2006, continues to decline in India? Yes, are you getting my point? When the government has banned the veterinary use of diclofenac, then why is the vulture population still declining in the country? The reason is the diclofenac is continuously available in the human use, and it will be diverted for the veterinary use through the black marketing in certain parts of the country. Now, why the veterinarian or these veterinary doctors, they prefer this diclofenac still? Because the meloxicam is not produced in required quantity in India. Yeah, it is not produced in required quantity. Second, meloxicam is costly. Okay, it is costly, it is not cost effective. And for that purpose, jo diclofenac painkiller injection hota hai for human use, this is diverted for the animal use. Okay, in that way, in spite of ban, the cattle continue to accumulate this diclofenac. So here you have to remember the alternative. You have to remember this year also when the government has banned this diclofenac. Yes, have you understood the reason for the decline in vultures? Now, see, Indian vultures, if you are looking at, this also can be important because we have 9 species. See, globally, how many are there? 23. Okay, 23 different species are there. India has 9 species of vulture. Someone was saying that India has all the species. No, India is not having all the species. Right, we have 9 species that is known as Oriental white-backed. Okay, now if questions are there, you don't get the scientific name. Okay, you are not getting the question on the scientific name. Remember, you will get the generic name. A question on generic name. So remember these names here. So yeah, slender bill, long billed Egyptian, red-headed vulture, Indian griffon vulture, Himalayan griffon, and cinereus vulture, and bearded vultures. Okay, so out of this, what are categorized as critically endangered? Matlab, iska population has drastically declined and they are very few adult are left in these categories that will be known as critically endangered. To kya hai? It will be white rumped vulture. Okay, ab isme common dekh lijiye. So in all these scientific name, what is common word? This. Theek hai? So most of the species which belong to this category or genus, you say, they are going to be critically endangered here. Okay. So in general, you remember like white rumped, white backed, Ruppell's vulture, Indian vulture, and slender billed vultures. They are now considered as critically endangered. Clear. So now conservation of vulture, what to do if you want to protect vulture? And conservation of vulture is essential because we need to balance the ecosystem. Balancing of the ecosystem is essential for us. Stability of the ecosystem is essential for us. So one of the method of conservation of vulture is VSZ. VSZ is vulture safety zones. Means, can we have one area where there is no use of diclofenac? Right? There is a region where there is no use of diclofenac. Okay, so this will be referred as vulture safety zone. Right? So this is a unique concept adopted in Asian countries. Yeah, it is a in situ conservation. Okay, it is in situ, not a ex situ conservation. Okay, within the habitat itself it is done. Let us assume that this is a forest, and in this forest the radius of 150 km, okay, where the vultures are residing, that area, and with the radius of 150 km, this is declared as no diclofenac zone. This is declared as no diclofenac zone. So means what? If any village is there or cattle are present in this 150 km of radius, they will not be treated with any such drugs. There will not be any use of this diclofenac. Means what? This meloxicam will be made available. You can understand in this way. And if the cattle, now whatever number of cattle are there here, these cattle are registered. Registered means the government has the record of all the cattle which are present with the farmers in this region. Right? Then if the cattle dies here in vulture safety zone, in the village, let us say a cattle is dying. Okay, cattle is dying, then what will happen? The farmer has to inform the death of these cattle to the forest department or to the government, okay, and hand over the dead body of these cattle, okay, hand over the dead body of these cattle to the forest department, right? And for this purpose, so vulture safety zone mein ek unique ye hai ki when the farmer is giving this dead body of the cattle to the forest department, the farmer is going to get some incentive. So financial benefit hai farmer ko, and the forest department will conduct some test on this dead body. They will check whether this chemical is as a residue is there in the dead body or not. Okay, right, it is there in the dead body or not. And if they are having that assurance ki isme koi chemical nahi hai, in such cases they will put this dead body into the forest feeding these vultures, right? If they find that there is some problem, there is some residue, in such cases they are not giving. So this is going to protect the vulture from such chemicals. ठीक है, तो vulture safety zone का मतलब है, it is no diclofenac zone, no diclofenac zone. इसमें ये unique concept है which involves or requires the participation of the farmers, awareness among the farmers, and it is based on incentivization. Clear? So defining diclofenac means what? We can say that it is a painkiller, okay, or at the most what we can say is non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug. This is what is a technical thing, that is what you require, right? Somebody is asking to define a diclofenac. So now where are these VSZ implemented in India? VSZ is spread around these regions, okay, so particularly the states of Uttarakhand. Remember the state, you need not go for in particular places, okay, then it is in the state of UP and this Tarai region. Tarai region is what the Indo-Nepal border, okay, Indo-Nepal border. So remember, the VSZ has become very popular as a part of implementation in Uttarakhand, UP and Indo-Nepal border. Now, so what I have explained, you can find here, the safe VSZ provides a safe source of food that is free from contamination of contamination from veterinary drug, toxic chemicals or any other agriculture chemicals. A place where vulture can feed free from human disturbance, okay, then supplement the ever decreasing food base of the vulture. Matlab kya hai? It is going to continuously provide some or the other food to the vultures. So extra food, increasing food will help in improving the populations of vulture. Okay, that is what this statement says, that extra food close to the breeding colonies, this will help in increasing their breeding success by improving the survival chance of the young vultures. And additional food such as bone fragment, which can be supplied to the breeding birds. Okay, so just remember what is the procedure and what are the advantages of this vulture safety zone. And it is also an economical and practical way of disposing the old and unproductive cattle bodies or dead bodies. It will help in reducing the risk of spreading, okay, spreading the diseases, okay, and it will help in raising public awareness on the vulture conservation and also help in raising the funds, right? So there is some concept that is known as vulture restaurants. Okay, have you come across this vulture restaurants? What is this vulture restaurants? Vulture restaurant be a concept. So in a given habitat, suppose this is a forest, right? How you will understand this concept of, because the government of Maharashtra has initiated this, Punjab also has initiated, okay, vulture restaurants. So this is also we are taking the help of the behavior of any species. Jaise pigeon mein hota hai. Suppose one day at one place you are just feeding 2-3 pigeons. Next day 10 will come if you go and feed them there. Next month you will find 100, okay, and they will keep on coming to that place only. That is their behavior. This is a behavior of a pigeon. They will come to the same place for getting the food. Okay, if you are able to feed them at one place, they will keep on coming to that place only. Similarly, the same behavior is found in case of vultures. Okay, they will be we can say geographically attached. Okay, geographically attached to one particular location where they get continuous availability of food. That is how the Tower of Silence is working, or any such tribal areas where the dead bodies, human dead bodies, are also disposed of. Now, how is that? The vultures, they will be sitting around them, waiting for any body to arrive. Okay, or they will be coming to this place with the expectation that there is a food available for them. So in this forest, if you are marking this area and you keep a dead body continuously here, the cattle bodies here, okay, the vultures from all these forests will get adjusted to come and feed in this region, and they will not feed here and there. Okay, they will not eat from other parts of this forest where there is a greater risk. Are you getting? So you can provide a safe food to the vulture at one particular location. So you decide or you fix a dining place for vulture. This concept is known as vulture restaurants. Yes, are you able to understand this? Yes, Parvinder, Sujay, Aftab. Ankit, so vulture safety zone ek concept hai. Vulture restaurant is another concept. Right now, so there is a collaboration that is known as save, S-A-V-E. What is this? Saving Asia's vultures from extinction. Okay, saving Asia's vulture from extinction. Right. Yeah, vultures restaurants will be a part of vulture safety zone. Yes, correct. You can have these vulture restaurants, a dining place for them inside the vulture safety zones. So SAVE stands for Saving Asia's Vulture from Extinction. This is to respond to the vulture crisis in Asia by striving to halt vulture population decline. Means what? Prevent the vulture population decline and working to minimize their negative impact on ecological and human health. Okay, so we can say this is a program which is undertaken in South Asia or Asian countries. Okay, Asian countries, and this is again to address the issues related to decline in vulture population. So when it was set up or started, SAVE was established in 2011 as a consortium to coordinate and drive forward the ambitious long-term international conservation effort. Okay, remember this, SAVE Saving Asian Vultures from Extinction. It is 2011. Okay, and this is implemented in the countries. So India, Nepal, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Myanmar, Bhutan, Cambodia. These are the countries where this save is implemented. These are the main breeding centers for the save, apart from all the Malayan region. So you have remaining countries of Malaya Peninsula, okay, which also wherein this project is taken up. Right. So this is about, so main thing will be, you have to understand here that why is this vulture population in the country is declining. Now this is funded through WWF, okay, it is funded by WWF, and it is a separate save is a separate initiative. In India, you have Ministry of Environment and Forest. Okay, this is the nodal agency for implementation of this or coordination of this program. Yeah, NSAID stands for non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug. Right, so this is about the species specific conservation. So in next class we will discuss, I think, yeah, you can suggest me like what can be the next topic I should deal in species specific, where you find it difficult to understand, like you have tiger, elephant, okay, crocodiles, okay, these are some of the important things to be covered. Hope you have understood this topic, and this is important also. So what we'll do is we'll do the tiger conservation project tiger in next class. So tomorrow's tomorrow we'll have class, but tomorrow's class will be 10:30 p.m. Okay, night it will be 10:30 to 11:30. Ministry of Environment and Forest. Right, so we'll meet in next class then. Thank you. NSAID, I told, that is non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug.